Drawings, it's calculations, it's distances, and these things don't make for a good presentation. So, given that we have cretins out there who would show any old drawings, it's calculations, it's distances, and these things don't make for a good presentation. So, given that we have cretins out there who would show any old and not consider how it's going to affect the new person who's looking into the flat earth. Picture you're new to the flat earth, you come across Laurie and Lawrence, and you see their gibberish. I wouldn't be, I think, oh my God, those guys are so full of shit. Please excuse my language, guys, I just get a little bit emotional sometimes. So, the thing is, we don't have the presentation ready. We want to demonstrate everything so that everybody can see exactly how it's been put together and exactly how things are. We don't have a presentation that we're all viewing, that we all know, that we're going to say, let's show it next week. Let's just string this out. No, we've had 2 weeks. Cammy put it together 2 weeks ago. She was bursting with the need to express it. She expressed it. And we've been thinking, when she was expressing it, I was thinking, oh my God, this is going to be so difficult to present in terms of visuals. Because we're on freaking YouTube, you know. We can talk as much as anybody. We can certainly talk as much as freaking Lawrence, you know. But we don't want to. Bob wants to present something that is coherent. So that's why this is happening. So we're going to show everything that has been used to put the presentation together, but the presentation isn't finished. And now, I'll wrap up now, Bob. There's an extra element that nobody's keeping kind of firm, and it's this. We know there are people viewing who don't have channels or who are not viewing through their channel. Their number's not registering. We know this. We also know that some of the people viewing, or at least we suspect, some of the people viewing would be professional people, okay? Professionally minded people. People who don't want to engage with a movement or with a community or with whatever, if all they see are half-assed jobs, okay? There's no level of professionalism. So Bob wants to present something that's a professional presentation. Now, once this is done, I would wager that some of the professionals out there who are staying quiet, who might work for engineering firms, who might work with electronics, who might work for NASA, professional people, some of them might be encouraged to actually contribute because they've seen something that's well presented and well put together and can add elements to it. What won't happen is nobody will say, Australia's in the wrong place. No. What will happen is people will come in with extra elements that confirm, that tweak, but there won't be any, this is wrong. So I just wanted to say that it's going to encourage professional people to contribute who are just, you know, watching silently. And we want to present something professionally. We don't want to have, bringing a sock in the background like Lawrence did in one of his videos, a sock. I don't know if it was dirty or not, but it was in the fucking background. You know, we want to have something professional and polished. That's right. It, guys.
Okay. All right. Well, Dan, thank you for saying that. And that pretty much sums up exactly how I feel about it. So, and with that, you know, we'll move on a little bit further. And we're going to explain this in pieces and parts and ultimately put it all together. And believe me, this is going to be something that is going out to the community when we definitely, I mean, we want to share this more than anything, but we also don't want to bring on any more criticism than, is absolutely necessary because we already know, you know, where we're getting that from or where we will be getting it from. So, okay, so getting back to this, we are going to, in putting together this map, we are going to be using a lot of the Robotham information, a lot of the old-time flat earth assumptions, that there is indeed Mount Meru in the center of the earth at the North Pole, and that this Mount Meru is made out of magnetite.
But don't think they meant it, Paul.